All right, good question time. Florida has nearly 700 miles of beaches.
Some places like Sanibel and Captiva are known for shelling, but one beach is especially known for predators from the past. Matt in Fort Myers asked the good question, why is Venice such a hotbed for hunting shark's teeth? To get the answer, Chad Oliver traveled there. Venice Beach is south of Sarasota, north of Inglewood. Chad, what did you find?
Well, Kelly and Peter, we found a lot of people who know of Venice's reputation for shark's teeth. When you find a shark's tooth, you're actually finding the fossil of a shark's tooth. That'll get your attention, huh? Like human teeth, shark teeth are white. When sharks lose them over a period of years, they get buried underneath sediment and turn a darker color through thousands of years of fossilization. Yeah, even the smaller black shark's teeth are considered fossils. Venice's position on Florida's coast makes it perfectly suited to be the shark's tooth capital of the world. This is Casperson Beach.
Every beach has fish stories, but in these parts, you're more likely to hear tales of teeth.
Megalodon, yeah, it was about that big, and she showed me a picture of it.
Some look like they're panning for gold. Others bring their own homemade tools.
There's like a little bit of a hill, and there's a whole bunch of shells right there, and you just sift right into it, and that's normally where they're at.
What do you do? What do you look for?
I dig a hole.
Whatever the strategy.
Dig and hope, I guess.
Well, I don't know if I should be giving away any secrets.
The goal is the same.
Ever since I was younger, I came down here and we'd always find them.
But why?
I wish I could answer that question, and that's a question that I wonder about.
I can answer that.
The president of the Southwest Florida Fossil Society points out two answers.
Between Inglewood Beach and Nokomis, and Venice is in the middle of that, you have a very gently sloping shelf.
That means there's not a steep drop-off. It's the perfect slope for the current to wash up fossils.
As it gets deeper very gradually, it erodes into the fossil layer very slowly.
From Venice Beach, go 1 mile into the Gulf of Mexico, and you'll find the main source of the shark teeth.
There's an old ancient river bottom out there, and they call it the boneyard because everything is collected in the bottom of the river.
The boneyard is where Chuck Ferrara found this.
This is a megalodon. Carcharian megalodon. It was the ancient giant shark that lived here in Florida.
We have a good answer.
Layer by layer, the fossil layer just keeps getting washed away and you're finding it.
Okay. I did not know that.
And that's why you have the shark's tooth capital of the world.
And because of Florida's climate and how it's formed, this state is primed for fossils. So go out, have fun on the beach, collect your shark's teeth. You don't need a permit when you're on the beach collecting the shark's teeth. But if you're diving looking for fossils, you will need a permit from the state. Matt in Fort Myers, that is a very good question. So Kelly and Peter, head on out to Venice and go
now
find some shark's teeth.
That is such a good question.
You have a boy, so I knew that one would pique your interest.
And I've always wanted to go there because I've heard you find shark's teeth, but I thought, well, they have to be all gone if everybody knows about it, but I guess they aren't.
The boneyard keeps giving.
Thanks a lot.